Hi, this is Naomi with the Top Shelf VA TV, your place for creativity and inspiration for business and life. One of the new Camtasia 9 recorder features is its default setting is to automatically load into the Camtasia media bin in Canvas when you are finished recording and shut down the recorder. Here's an example. What we'll cover in this tutorial is how to change the default settings in the Camtasia 9 recorder. However, a quick reminder, please subscribe to the channel and make sure to turn on notifications so you know right away when a new video is loaded. Now here's why I don't like the Camtasia 9 recorder default being set automatically to save and insert into Camtasia. Although it is nice having it automatically set into the Camtasia 9 work area, here is where all the recordings are stored. First, all the recordings are saved into one folder. Second, does this file title tell you anything about the recording other than the date? Third, if you do more than one recording in the day, does 1, 2, 3 with the date tell you anything about that recording? When doing screencast recordings, I prefer having all recordings in their own separate folders, with all assets specific to that video in the subject folder and its subfolders. When doing Camtasia screencasts, it's much easier to keep everything in the project folder for the specific project. 3 months from now, will you know what this is by looking at it compared to this? Which list of recordings will be easier for you to know what is what? So how do we change the Camtasia 9 recorder defaults in order to tell it where to save the recording and give it a proper file name? Open the recorder and go to Tools and Options. On the General tab, click on File Options. Then select Ask for File Name and then OK. Now go to the Program tab. There are two ways to do this, depending on how you work. First, if you tend to do one Camtasia screencast project at a time, under Workflow and under Do This With My Recording, select Add to Media Bin and then OK. Now, when you stop recording, it will ask where you would like to save the file. I do want to keep the date of the recording, so I will put the name of the recording at the beginning of the date and then save. Camtasia will then save the recording and put it into the media bin for you. If you don't want it to automatically go into the media bin, let's say you normally work by doing several different Camtasia screencasts in a row, well, back in the recorder under Tools Options, you can go to the Program tab in the Camtasia 9 recorder, and under Workflow, and then under Do This With My Recording, select Save, and then OK. When you stop recording, it will ask where you would like to save the file. It will only save the file, but not put it into your media bin, and it will keep the Camtasia 9 recorder open. Then you can record more screencasts, or you can close out of the Camtasia recorder. When you are ready to work on your project, you can then open Camtasia, click on Import Media, find the recording you wish to import, and open it into the media bin. There you have it, an easy way to change the Camtasia 9 recorder's defaults to custom settings that allow you to record your Camtasia screencasts and save in a way that works for you. If you have a question and you would like me to create a Camtasia tutorial video for you, simply subscribe to the channel, like this video, and leave a comment below. Feel free to share this video on any of your other social media platforms and encourage your friends to subscribe to this channel. As always, this is Naomi with TopShelfVA.com. Until we meet again, have a wonderful day.